What is up, Dark Shots? And today we're going to be reviewing the Transformers Combiner Wars Motor Master. And there he is, and you just don't know when. Something just fell. So here is Motor Master, and this is my first time handling a Combiner Wars Optimus Prime mold, which is, he is just a remold of Optimus Prime. And they made him a mean ass truck. That is some mean truck right there. I like this. So let's take a look at the details right there. You do get gray for the, you do get yellow for the headlights as well. You do get a bits of black on the front, but it kind of kills the silhouette, how it looks. You get silver for the grill. Decepticon somewhere right there. Purple on the windshield. On the windows. Sadly, there's nothing back right there. There is painted windshield right there. I don't get why they don't paint the rest of it. This side too. But I really like this I really like the striping they made here. I think that's really cool. You do get that wind vane on top right there. That thing paints out the smokestacks. So, in the back, of course, I'm using the Optimus Prime mold as expected. So, here's the top. Here's the bottom. And he rolls. Smoothly, actually. He rolls very smoothly. And for comparison, here it is with the Legacy Motor Master. If I could get it to be in frame. Push it back a little. There you go. Here's the Legacy Motor Master. And overall, I still prefer the Legacy Truck Mode over the Combiner Wars. I know people didn't enjoy the Combiner Wars line, but I'll tell you about that when we get into Minasaur. So, for accessories, it does come with a huge sword. Now, this can split into two. And you can see there's a slot right there that goes into that tab. You just tap it in, and then you just peg it into the back. And if you tap it in, it kind of falls everything apart so slowly. There you go. That's your average. So there's nothing else to talk about the truck. Now let's get down to transformation, shall we? Let's. So first thing you want to do is you want to take the wind vane and flip that forward. You want to take the panel on the side. You want to undo this. Oh, one side's already done. You want to take one side, and you can see there's a tab. I'm recording in here, and someone's gonna be pain in the ass to edit. You want to take the panel, bring it down, and for some reason this one is tight. There you go. You want to bring it down, and then you want to untap the arms. You can see there's two tabs right there. There's two tabs right there that goes into that slot where my thumbnail is. You want to bring his arms down like this. You want to split the cab. Bring it to the back. Bring the arms out. This ratchet joint is really tight, not this one. You want to bring the legs down if it's undone so already. You want to untap the crotch. You want to take this tummy section. You want to bring it forward. Bring this down. And now you want to take the crotch the combined macrons and tab it in. Take the feet, flip that up, and then you want to take the arms, rotate them forward, and we might raise the camera up, and then we'll take the spindle and then bring us forward. So there you have Motormaster. Let me raise the camera a bit so you can see what I'm doing here. So there you have Motormaster in his robot mode. And he is pretty good, but he's my least favorite. Not because he's bad, but it's just the other Stunticons I enjoy the most, like Dead End and Dragstrip, I enjoy a lot. But Motormaster isn't bad. They did a good job remolding the upper body. They gave him Optimus Prime legs because that's what the mold is based off. And then they didn't remold legs, they remolded the upper part. If you just give me a good old few seconds so I get down to details really quickly. I'm almost done. Give me a minute. There you go, now I'm done. So let's take a look at the details. Head sculpt looks nice, though. All things considered, the box head. You do get black and purple for the upper chest, and then bits of purple for the tummy. You do get bits of purple on the shoulders. Silver biceps because that's the truck mode grill. And you do get the gray forearms and hands, black thighs. And the legs are very Optimus Prime, but at least they gave him bits of purple. That's about it. Articulations wise, the head is on a ball joint, so you get to look up that far, look down, not all. And you can also do a 360. Shoulders can go through a 360. Arms can go through 90 degrees of bend at the elbow. You do get bicep rotation. Nothing at the rest, but you can do this. More for combined mode. Legs can kick forward that far, back that far, and knees can go through slightly over 90 degrees of bend at the knee, and the toe can go down due to transformation. No, that's about it. Send them straight. Now, the problem with the ratchets is you get this, and you get him to looking like that. If you get him like this, he's going to stand like this. But my copy, he stands just fine. Like, every time you're going to pick him up, his legs are going to slant back the way they back where they were. So, I do not have a problem. I do not find it to be a problem at all, to be honest. Now, as for the weapons, you could take his gun. My glasses fell. Take the gun. You could take the sword. So you can pew pew slash slash pew pew slash slash. So there you go. For comparison, here it is with the Legacy Motormaster. And this is a Voyager class, and he's bigger. And bigger doesn't mean it gets better. So, there you go. So, that is it for Combiner Wars Motormaster. Now, tomorrow I'm going to show you the combined mode for Motormaster, as tomorrow we'll be taking a look at the Combiner Wars Menasaur. And we'll see how that turns out, and it is not. So there you go. If you didn't see my Transformers Legacy reviews, check those out. If you didn't see my Transformers Studio Series reviews, check those out as well. And this is Dark Hot Wrestling. See you later, right, Dark Shots.